So welcome to my quick and dirty tutorial on how to play this song. This is the US edit of The Who's Who Are You. This is actually the first video I'm putting available on my channel, The Church Basement, which is the place where I'm going to be putting songs that I'm playing in church either the next week or the week before. And then I'm always going to have a link to the live version in the at the end of the video, so you can see how it was done live, and you can tell me whether I did a decent job or not. This song, one note about the live version is that it's in a different key. Our singer needed it down two tones to the key of C in order to sing it comfortably. So we did that, and that created a unique problem for me as a bass player, because I didn't want to play this in closed position. It's actually quite difficult to play in closed position. It's much easier to play in the original key of E or in an open position on one of the other strings, so like A or D. But it's quite hard to play in C. So what I ended up doing was playing it on my 5-string and then actually up-tuning the bass by a half a tone, so that I was playing in C on the bottom string, and the bottom low B became a C, and then I just played it exactly what I'm going to show you, but just down there. And so that is kind of a unique aspect of this. However, the original song's in E, so that's what I'm going to show you. We're going to have a really brief tutorial on it. It's not a particularly difficult song to play. There are some tricky bits, but it's not that hard. There's basically four parts to this song. There is a chorus part, then a verse part, there's a bridge part, and then there's an outro part. And if you can master the four of those, then you're set. So the first part that you have to play is the chorus part. There is actually a little high part in the intro. I'm not going to teach you that, and I didn't play it for the live version, and the reason why was just because it was in C, and I could have learned it in E fairly easily, I think, but trying to figure out how to transpose it all into C on the bass was just, I didn't have time for that, because I got like basically a week and a half or a week to practice this stuff, and I have 5 songs to learn, so I just left it. It starts out with that intro, and then it goes immediately into the chorus. And the chorus part is actually really, really simple. It's just a pedaling on E, so it's octaves on E. So just the low E, and then the E on the 7th fret on the 2nd string. So it just becomes... something like that. So... play it along with the record. If you do that, you'll pick it up super fast, because it's actually not hard at all. Okay, so the second part that you need to learn is the verse part. And the verse part is a little bit more challenging than the chorus part. The verse part has a pull on the first note in the phrase, and then repeated twice more before the little run. So what I mean by a pull is you hear about notes being pushed, meaning that they're being played before the beat. In this case, they're being played just after the beat. So it's like, ba-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum. And so you have to get that feel to that part. But other than that, the notes themselves are pretty easy. It's just E on the bottom and then E on the top, and then E on the bottom, and then D on the 2nd string, and then E on the 1st string, and then A on the 1st string, and then C, B, A, F sharp, G, D. So that's C on the 2nd string, B on the 2nd string, A on the 2nd string, F sharp on the 1st string, G on the 1st string, and then D is an open 3rd string. So when you put it together, it sounds something like... something like that. I kind of butchered the last bit, but you get the idea. The third part is the bridge, and like the verse, there is a pull going on here. So the part I'm talking about is the part that goes... So again, you're pulled on that. There's the drums come in right on the beat, and then you're like a half a beat behind it. And so you have to get that feel down, or it will not be right. But it's just behind, and then it's the E. So you're an eighth note behind the beat, and then it's the E on the bottom string, and then G on the third string, and D on the second string. So. And then there's a little bit where there's a walk down on the guitar that goes doo 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 doo. In that part, I felt it was kind of thin when we were playing it live, so I just I played just E's, but I did the pedaling thing again, so it's. Okay? And then the only other part that's any different from anything else is the outro. And in the outro, you play like the full chorus, and then coming out of that chorus, you just play A, and then G, and then A, and then E again for the end. So it sounds something like. And at the end, I'm just throwing in a A, B, A, G, E. And that's really the whole song. So thank you for watching my little tutorial. And I hope it's helped you if you really wanted to play this song yourself. I started this channel because I would often play songs. And before, you know, there'd be tricky parts in them. I'd be trying to figure out what the guy is playing, because, you know, the bass is sandwiched in with all the other instruments, and sometimes it gets covered up by the keyboard, especially the left hand of the keyboard, and it isn't easy to hear. But you can hear something's going on, and you're just like, what exactly is going on? And so I was really in debt. I found a couple of songs that we played where there were really good tutorials online, and I thought, that is so helpful for people, so I'm going to do it for myself. So this is not about me making money or anything like that. I don't need it. It's about me giving back to the other bass players and helping people who are coming behind me. So I hope this little tutorial is helpful. If you want to see the live version, click up here. You know, the like, subscribe, comment, they all feed the algorithm, so feel free to do that if you want other people to see what I've got to show. So hope you have a great day, and enjoy the live version. Take care.